Generative AI is a very hot field right now. The most common app in the field is Chatbot. Chatbot is nothing but a web interface that simulates human conversation. Trust me, it's very very easy to build a chatbot with AI tools such as Chainlit and Streamlit. Chainlit is an open source Python tool that allows you to build conversation AI apps. Today, I'll show you how to create a question answering chatbot with Chainlit and OpenAI. Here is the app we built. We write our question here and then the app will return the response. Simple but cool, right? Let's take a look at the topics we cover. First, we'll create a virtual environment and install the tools we'll use. Next, we'll set the OpenAI model. Lastly, we'll build the chatbot app with Chainlit. Nice! We've seen topics we'll handle. Let's dive in. To write our code, we're gonna use the VS Code editor. Now, let's create a virtual environment. To do this, we're gonna use Conda. Let's write Conda create dash n. Let's name Gen AI. I already created this. After that, we're gonna activate this environment. Conda activate Gen AI. Here you go. Our environment is ready to use. The next step we're gonna do is install the tools we'll use. To do this, let's create the requirements.txt file. We're gonna click on the new file and then name it requirements.txt. After that, let's write the libraries we'll use here. We're gonna type OpenAI. After that, let's write Chainlit. Lastly, let's type Python.env. This tool help us to get the environment variables. For now, these tools are enough to build the app. We're gonna now install this. It's simple to do this with pip. Let's write pip install dash r. Let's write requirements.txt. Here you go. Our tools are ready to use. To write our code, we're gonna create a Python file. Let me click on the new file and then give a name. Let's say app.py. Yeah, our file is ready. So far, we created a virtual environment. Let's go ahead and set the environment variable. To do this, we're gonna use the .env tool. First, let's create an env file. Let me click on the new file and then .env. Okay, our file is ready. Here, we're gonna set the OpenAI API key. OpenAI API key. Let me paste the OpenAI API key. You can get this API key from the OpenAI website. Okay, all we need to do now is load this API key with .env. First, let's import load.env method. Let's go to the app file and then write from .env import load.env. Next, let's use this method load.env. That's it. The API key is ready. It's simple, right? So far, so good. Let's go ahead and initialize our chatbot with Chainlit. First, we're gonna import this tool. Import Chainlit SCL. Next, let's define an async function. To do this, first, let's use a Chainlit decorator. CL.onMessage. This decorator tells Chainlit to call this function when a new message is received. Now, let's create a function. We're gonna use the async keyword. This keyword allows various tasks to be executed in parallel. Next, let's type def, let's name onMessage. Let's give an argument message CL dot, let's call the message class. Now, we're gonna send a response back to the user. To do this, let's create a new object from the message class. Let's write await and then let's call the message class. Next, let's pass a content. Content. Let's give a message content. To do this, we're gonna use the f string. Let's say received. Let's pass. We wanna return the message. Message dot content. To send the response message, let's use the send method. Let's write send. Note that when a user inputs a message, the function will be called. Great! Our function is ready to use. It's time to run this app. To start this app, let's open the terminal and write chainlit run app.py-w. This flag tells chainlit to enable auto-reloading. This means that you don't need to restart the server every time you make change to your app. When we're gonna press enter, the chatbot UI opens on the localhost. Voila! Here is our simple chatbot app. When you enter a text here, you can get a response. Let's write, hi. As you can see, the app returned the message. Awesome! Our app works very well. If you want, you can start a new chat. Pressing over here. Click on the new chat button. You can modify this welcome screen. To do this, we're gonna edit the chainlit.md file. Let me click over here. If you don't want a welcome screen, just leave this file empty. Like this. We're gonna just type welcome to QA chatbot. Okay, let's take a look at the welcome screen. There you go. It's simple, right? Let's go ahead and add the OpenAI model to our app. To do this, first, we're gonna import the async OpenAI class from the OpenAI. From OpenAI import async OpenAI. Next, let's initialize an object from this class. Let's say client equals, let's write async OpenAI. After that, we need to add cl.instrument.openai. Next, let's set the model. To do this, let's create a variable named response in the function. Response equals, let's set await, let's pass client.chat.completions.create. First of all, let's set the OpenAI model. Model, it can be GPT 3.5 Turbo. All we need to do now is create roles and contents. To do this, let's set messages. First, let's create a system role. Role, let's set system. Next, let's give content. Let's write, you are a helpful assistant. Next, let's create a user role. Role. Next, pass user. Let's set content. Let's write message content. What we're gonna do now is return the response. To do this, let's set the content. Let's write response choices. Let's type the message and content. Nice! The model is ready to use. It's time to test the app. Let's go to the app and write tell me a short joke. Let me press enter. There you go. As you can see, our app works very well. Let's go ahead and ask a question. Why is the sky blue? There you go. You can see the response here. Yeah, that's it. In this video, we covered how to build a chatbot app with Chainlit and OpenAI. As you can see, it's simple to create an app with these tools. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and leave a comment. See you in the next video. Bye for now.